The textures created by different chords are investigated now on Two by youngsters best described as mad about music.
Another one of my big ideas was a song that Kev and I wrote. Basically, like every song we do, it's an interplay between the two people. At any given time, somebody has the role to interject and say, whoa, hold everything, or the other guy can say, no, hang on a minute, I want to take it further. So basically, we set up the drum machine with a fairly dancey groove that we thought had, you know, a nice pop aspect. But because of the lyric, another one of my big ideas, we just thought it had a sadness to it. We wanted to add something that had a, like almost a joke really to it, is the word. So, what we did was add some chords. I always use strings for the first sound because it's a very warm, what we call a paddy sound, with lots of texture in there that can give you many ideas for melody writing. So you'll hear that immediately when I play. Very sad, but it's very rich and very symphonic, and it can give you hundreds of ideas for melodies when you actually get to write the tune. Basically, what you can do with a chord like this is by adding notes, you can give it a different texture and therefore a sadder feel or a bluesier feel or whatever. With the four we had, in its basic form, it would sound like this, which is, this is what I call the boring basic run through. Now by adding notes, with the A, you add this note up here, you can hear it in the chord. Suddenly it takes on a much richer texture. With the second, we add a different sound here. But keeping the third and fourth the same, because you don't want too rich a recipe. All together you get this. Foreign.
Put the drums up there for a second.
Sure.
Right? Started looking at other ways of actually getting in. If I had.
Hole.
So that was giving me a totally different idea. And I decided I didn't like the second note very much. So I changed that to an F sharp. That was feeling better. But then I didn't like the fact the rhythm was so broken. So then it ended up evolving into this.
By this time, Kevin was already conjuring up some guitar textures. Pan over to there.
Well, we tried, you know, a few power chords and things, but found really that what the chorus itself needed was not a power guitar treatment so much as maybe a little bit of crying counterpoint type thing like going on in the background. So, Nick, if you play me the chords, I'll show another line.
Two, three, four.
something that's a little bit sad and crying, but quite subliminal. But all of a sudden, this was setting us off in pursuit of new textures as well in the overall arrangement.